All right, we going? We're going. Episode 4. Didn't know it came out. Anyway, let's start. Forgot to turn crowd play on as usual. Oh well, who cares? My face is very blue. Let's turn the correct light on. That's a little better. All right. Mike is on, OBS is on, got the chat going. Previously on story mode. Sorry, Hibbert. How do you face a foe who's never exactly as he seems? Wait, my best friend. Do you hide who you really are? Not everyone can face a trickster head on. Join him. Like I did. Me, the traitor among men. Even when they're scared. No matter what, encountering that kind of evil changes you. Prison Radar is never scared. A hero? Or something else. If there's a lesson to be learned. Ooh. Forgot he died from 2 days ago. Oh, let's kick it off. Let's go. Me and you. Oh, just give me the chance to see me decide to have a Uber play. Nailed it. Oh, what? Is the building upside down? No. No, it's not. Okay.
Don't worry, everyone. This is just like the time I jumped from the cliffs of Nepal. Only, who am I kidding? This is nothing like that.
Jack, you little rascal. Again for not leaving me behind.
Though, let's be honest. No way you'd pick some llama over Nermi here.
She's not just some llama. Luna's back there all alone.
Quiet, just stay quiet. That's an awkward question.
Guess I'm the only one who cares.
Oh, I'm sorry, Prison Radar. I almost asked who had the gauntlet. I remember he put the gauntlet on himself.
Wow, you were right. There's a whole world down here.
The first world, created by us, Romeo, Fred, and me.
Looks great.
Since I was imprisoned, before he bedrocked over it all.
You made this?
Not this. This shadow. The view from up here.
Ah, this must be hard for you. You want to talk about it like best friends? Like best friends do?
How long have you been gone exactly?
No idea. It's hard to keep track of the time in maximum security. Long enough for the world to change. I knew what Romeo planned to do. But still, seeing it like
the admin.
Worse than I imagined. This is the room where he killed Fred. I watched it happen. We refused to join him and
it made you stronger.
Slow.
That sounds so awful. Just walk in. Hey, Fred! Oh, you're alive.
Want to defeat Romeo? The weapon's in there.
It's another gauntlet.
Vaguely ominous.
Is that?
That is the biggest Enderman I've ever seen.
Romeo never could leave well enough alone. He liked toying with the basic order of things.
Oh god, that is big.
It would be great if I could go one day, just one day, without seeing something new and completely terrifying.
Your Prison Radar, you can't be scared. Never. Oh, he just punched out the ceiling. Where are they? Jump, idiot! Push him, push him. Push. Oh, A. Ow. How much fall damage is this guy gonna take before he dies?
Thanks.
Dismantling the tower. A. Is that green water? Oh, X. How am I not taking fall damage? That's... Come on. Like, if we could jump that far in actual Minecraft, then I would never die. Compared to dying all the time.
I'll lead the way. Fred's keep lies just on the other side, and we'll have some cover from that thing.
Stupid shield.
What? Do you guys see?
It's the ninja! Randy Cunningham. That's what I'm gonna call him until I get a name. That's Randy Cunningham, ninth grade ninja. What's with the music? Nicole Martinez, Juan Vaca. Zombie pigmen are nice as long as you don't hit them. What? He knocked over the camera. Ah! Now they're all running. No emotion on the features. How come Antelmio and Wells don't have a either last name or first name? Spider, 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 crawl.
Is this place safe?
You tell me, genius.
Not asking for me, cause I'm tough. Whatever.
Our defenses are impressive. State-of-the-art machinery, automated farming. The Oasis is a completely self-sustaining city. It's home.
So it's destroyed, right?
What? What happened to it?
It looks nice.
This place looks... It looks nice.
Put your teeth away. I know what it looks like. This isn't right.
You know.
This is your town? What has he done to it?
He obviously took away the defenses, let monsters breathe, and let it go on fire. Like everything else around the whole world, stupid.
No telling what the admin is up to in Beacon Town. And they'll all think it's me.
Oh, Nermy, Nermy, it's okay. Come here, pal, it's okay.
I'm confused.
Are you guys okay?
Nerm here was poking around and found a llama blanket, and it made him think of
Luna the Llama.
Nermy, no. Come on, pal. No. Oh, jeez.
I know it's kind of hard to think about, but Luna really is safer in the Sunshine Institute. Fighting the admin could be really dangerous.
Wow. Way to make him feel better. Great! Now the llama's safe and I could die. I mean, Nerm.
Yeah. Thanks, Jesse.
Years without sleep! Years! Only rest is at home. Won't rest until I get there, I said.
Zara?
Look! At this. My bed. Come on.
She's freaking out about a bed. Really? Could she be any more melodramatic?
No!
should help her.
Be my guest. I'm staying.
my bed. Where will I respawn when I die?
I just wanted to sleep. I thought if I could find this one thing, one last thing still whole, there's no hope for this place.
Who wants to make you a bed?
I'll never get it back now. He made sure.
He won't get away with this. We'll get back at the admin for what he did. Avenge your bed.
You really believe that?
You really believe I'm talking about just a bed? Yeah. Well, let's do that portion of the game and we walk around in a circle.
Zara, what are you doing over here by this,
This is...
portal.
What?
The portal. Broken now like everything else. Just leave me here.
But a little bit, you revenge. Oh, no, I'm tired, man.
What he did to you, your town. Then you have to get up.
Not much use stuck down here.
But what about the portal? Where does it go, anyway?
Your world.
Nowhere, obviously. It's broken. We built these so we could visit each other. An object in the frame would teleport you to the owner. My idea, by the way. Though Romeo took credit for it. Fred wanted to add the birch. He loved birch.
So you'd know how to rebuild it and get us up to the admin.
I don't know if I can.
Sure you can.
Come on, Zara, if you built it once, you can build it again. You're the best inventor in the underneath.
Probably the only inventor now.
Even better?
You keep going. Look where you are, but you're still fighting. Why?
The admin hurt the people I care about. Nobody gets away with that. Nobody.
Wow. Had that real emotion. Nobody gets away with that. Nobody.
Fine. It won't work without a personal object. Something with a strong bond to Romeo to take us right to him. Though an object crafted on the surface could do in a pinch.
Let me worry about finding an object for the portal. You just focus on getting it running.
Follow the tracks. They'll lead you to Fred's keep. Whatever Fred found, he hid it at home. That's what he told me.
Jesse!
Go. I'll see what I can do.
I just sneezed really bad. Okay. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. That was quick.
Zara said to follow the tracks to Fred's keep. That's where we'll find the weapon.
Kind of useless unless we can find a way out of here. Can't exactly go back up through that prison.
Zara's got it covered.
Creepers! But here they explode confetti.
Jesse?
Oh, jeez, Rick.
No. Who made eye contact with the Enderman?
Me!
Go!
I hate you, Radar. I hate you so much. Hey, achievement.
It's okay. We're still okay, so long as it doesn't.
Oh, man, I got stuck with Jack.
Jack!
I'm okay!
No, I'm not!
No! Need to stop saying that!
They're holding on to gravel.
You two are in a bit of a pinch, ain't ya? Smell like a couple of admin lackeys to me. AKA Trouble.
Oh, what?
I'm Jesse.
We've been scavenging these lands since the darkness fell. You know what? We can sniff out an outsider when we
sniff one.
So what are you doing all the way down here, Small Fry? You lost?
We're here to take down the admin.
You're kidding. You can't even make it off this gravel cliff by yourself.
Calm down.
Maybe we help you. Maybe we just walk away. Leave you here to die.
The first one. Pick the first one.
I don't know. Seems like a lot of work. Getting down there. Pulling you up.
You should help us because it's the right thing to do. If you see someone in trouble, you have to do something.
You think any of this down here is right?
We'll take you to our world, where we have sun and water. Mostly water.
Maybe I do feel a little sorry for you, though. Here's the deal, folks. Down here, we don't do anything for free. Can't really blame us, what with the giant monsters and nothing growing. So, how about we take your inventory for a spin? Permanently! We're really interested in any weaponry you may have.
Warrior without their sword in a place like this is dead meat.
Your friend doesn't look like he's gonna last much longer. What'll it be?
Jack, get a grip.
We can find another way.
Your swords or splat, flatter than a lily pad at the bottom of this canyon.
Splat. Here, take the damn sword.
And one more makes two.
Fine, but pull me up first.
Somebody help! Again, that's not that big a fall.
All right, I admit it. That would have been one nasty fall. Thank you.
That he pushes off.
You'll ever have the pleasure of meeting.
Hiya.
Sup. Best be careful as you get on your way. You're looking a little squishy. Seriously, though, watch out.
Thank you.
Never know when a cliff will just jump out at you.
Thanks for your help.
Thanks for this beauty. Oh, and make sure to keep your pockets stocked for next time, alright?
Oh, these kids are annoying.
One last piece of advice? Keep your eyes peeled. You're not alone down here.
No fooling.
Yeah, squiggies!
Hey, my friends. What are you doing? Where's your sword? You expect me to fight this by myself? I mean, I can, but I shouldn't have to.
Stupid scavengers, stupid cliffs. This never would have happened.
Okay, that's it. What happened up there?
Oh, we got shaken down by a couple of scavengers, and they took our swords.
Well, at least you're okay, right?
I guess. Just haven't felt this pathetic since... Well, it's been a long time.
Like last week.
To protect us against a normal Enderman, let alone a giant one.
Jack, are you or are you not the raging storm of Chun? Is it Chun?
Chunji Forest.
Right. We don't need a sword. You are a weapon.
Yeah, those scavs would have been terrified if they knew, right?
Horrified.
Hey, I made him feel better. That's good. Good for me. Jump, jump, jump. That place doesn't look that bad. Hey, a book.
Strangers. Strangers, Binta.
What do we do here, Jesse?
We come in peace. We're not gonna hurt you. I promise.
Oh, okay.
We've been told that before. Fred believed it. Then he was stabbed in the back.
Now what?
I've never seen you before, and I know everyone in the underneath. Binta!
She's not coming back, is she?
Someone in there has to know where that weapon is. Let's go.
Careful. They might be well-armed, and now they know we're coming.
Have been returned. Festivities will close with the fireworks display.
This place seems nice.
And don't forget to sign up for our Faithful Friends of Fred trivia competition for a chance to win one night in Fred's house. Come on, people. We can't let Kent win every time, can we? Study up. Competition starts at Fred o'clock.
Why did you say that? They're having a trivia contest? Doesn't that seem a little silly?
Silly?
You're trapped underground with a bunch
of... I love trivia!
Oh, man, I love trivia.
You do?
Yes! It's so fun! Flexing those brain muscles, taking your mind off the incredible misery in the world crushing down on you every... I mean, oh, look at that.
Hi!
Welcome to Fred's Keep. My name is Binta. This is the part where you tell me why you're here.
We're looking for a weapon that belonged to Fred. It's supposed to be hidden in his home.
Maybe we could take a look?
Fred's house is sacred. And locked. No one enters unless they win the contest.
Look at that wolf! It's now the standard wolf color!
Honor Fred. Even I only enter through its doors on special occasions.
Okay, let's do some trivia then.
That's the spirit. I wasn't sure an outsider would understand. Fred built this place. Made it safe from all the monsters out there. This is his legacy. His final request. The door stays locked until someone wins. You're welcome to try your luck. See how well you know Fred.
I don't know him very well at all. I've never met him.
Guess you better start researching.
Nah. Wing it.
This place is weird.
Hey, let's walk around. I'm gonna steal your bone.
Oh man, you are a serious fetch artist. Oh, you're a good dog. You're a good dog.
Obviously, this is the first thing I had to do. Aww. Play tug of war. Okay, I'm gonna leave Blocko. Here's your bone. Why do you look so angry? Oh, wait, something. This could come in handy.
Nice.
I don't want to talk to you. I can't talk to you. Let's talk to Kent.
So
you're the one. The one who thinks they can beat me as a faithful friend of Fred.
Hey, dude.
And I'll tell you something, stranger. I am the most faithful friend of Fred, which means I always win. And that means you will lose.
I mean, I always lose. I'm Matthew Wojo.
I don't even know what to do with that one.
Quite the walk.
know something about Fred?
Sure.
Yeah, actually, how did you...
His favorite tool, a diamond hoe. That's why I use two. And why I take farming my mushrooms super, super serious.
Two golden hoes. Oh, just one golden hoe. Yeah, she uses
sure.
two.
Makes sense. Bye.
That boy. Bye, jerk. Hi, scared girl.
Please, please, don't hurt me, stranger. I did what you asked.
Yeah, okay, don't freak out. Backing away, nice and non-threatening.
Let's see what's going on over here. Oh, are they telling them their stories? Is it?
The creepers never even stood a chance. The leader of Dreshnagel Valley was not an emotional man. But that day, he shed a tear.
That's one way to gather information, I guess.
Hey, let's see what's going on over here.
Myself to paint like this, but these old dogs aren't up to crafting. How about we make a trade? You craft me a canvas, and I'll tell you Fred's favorite color.
Okay.
You know, I got some wool, but not enough sticks. You'll have to find some more to get it done. Get that done, prompt like. I'm on a roll, and this one's almost finished.
Whoo!
Got it.
So I need wool? Talk to Petra real quick.
What are you up to?
Just trying to figure out if there's a better way into Fred's house than, well, studying. Just in case. Hey, Jesse?
Yeah?
Do you think Radar still thinks... I don't know. I feel like everyone's looking at me differently. You noticed it too, right? He's being weird with me.
He's overreacting.
Still with the admin or something.
You know how Radar can get. He's just overreacting. He'll get over it eventually.
I hope so. Just had to, you know, make sure I wasn't the only one who noticed.
Oh, I do have wool. I need a crafting table then. Here's one. I think. No. You gotta find a crafting table. Maybe it's one by Radar. Sticks.
I can definitely use these.
What?
You've been practicing.
Oh, well, thanks. I didn't know you were. Just want to be ready. Anyway, the Oasis and Fred's Keep are all, you know, kind of broken. But I wonder what this place looked like before. Bet it was amazing. The admin's not going to do this to Beacon Town, is he?
Oh, no, I'm not there.
What's going up there? It could be all gone, and we'd have no idea.
Standing between them and the admin.
And we will. We'll make sure nothing bad happens to them.
Oh, you're gonna die.
There's one thing I learned in the slammer. It said I have to keep my body ready for anything. One, two, and a half.
Okay, bye. Crafting table. Oh wait, more knowledge.
Hey there, I'm looking for information about Fred.
Well, this here was Fred's cherished pet, but you'll never guess his name.
Chicken?
You stay in there now. Don't want that dog getting you now, do we?
How can I get him to call out that chicken's name?
Let me make a canvas real quick. Maybe Shilt. Is his favorite... Is his name his favorite color? Okay, I'm just gonna assume. Yep.
Here you go. All done.
It's just lovely. I am going to paint this Fred's favorite color. Not just any
lapis blue.
Lapis blue. Oh, same color as my underwear.
Mine too.
So I think the... Oh, wait. I can still talk to her. Nope, poster. Okay, I think the only thing left to do is talk to her. Sure. Let's go.
Let's do this.
I'm gonna fail immediately.
Attention, everyone. Let all faithful friends of Fred gather, for our competition begins now.
Oh, her arms. I feel bad.
Gather around, everyone. Will the contestants please take the stage? Please welcome reigning champion.
I basically live in this house, for I am Fred.
Jesse. It's Jesse.
Jesse!
That feeling of intimidation? Totally normal. I have that effect on people.
Oh boy, let's see if I can do this.
What a pinnacle of intellectual fortitude!
May the most faithful friend of Fred win.
Oh, I will.
For our first question, I thought we'd mix it up a little. I challenge you to build a faithful representation of our dear Fred.
Yeah! Jesse's the best at building!
Not the time, Radar. Begin!
Okay. Oh, no. You know what? Let's build his face. No, okay. Oh, yeah, I can build up. I'm dumb. Okay. This is terrible. Finished. It's perfect.
Nice.
Yes, yes, yes. Jesse, it's as if you've known Fred his whole life.
What? How can you say that? That thing looks nothing like our fallen leader.
Fred's true spirit didn't lie with his exterior, Kent. But what was underneath? This is his true.
Oh, I did awful. How come he got...
I declare this round...
Oh, cool.
This was quite possibly the best presentation of Fred's in the history of our competition.
Is that it?
Now for the questions. Kent, you will go first.
Of course.
Remember, you have a limited time to answer. What was Fred's favorite...
Lapis Blue!
Oh, that's easy. Any truly faithful friend would know that Fred... enjoyed bread.
Correct.
Oh, wait.
Now you, Jesse. Fred was a loyal fan of the color blue. We all know that. But what kind of blue did he...
Lapis. Lapis.
His favorite color was lapis blue.
That is correct. Well done. Next question. Kent, Fred was a man of simple means. But he had one point of excess. His favorite tool.
Diamond hoe.
What was it?
A diamond hoe. Obviously.
Very good. Jesse, Fred had a constant companion. A fine, feathery friend. What was that pet's name?
Let's see.
He actually met a chicken named Benedict once. Really? Silence, please.
Waffles. Are you serious?
Well done. I am rather astounded that the competition continues to be...
Oh, boy.
Kent, you might finally lose your title. Listen closely, both of you. The final question is one that only the most faithful friend to Fred could possibly know. As such, it is worth double. Whoever answers this question correctly first will win one night in Fred's house. Of all the trees in the forest, of all the
birch
we once built our homes with, this was Fred's
birch. I know it.
What was it?
Wait, what?
Birch!
Fred didn't play favorites with resources.
It's birch. It's birch.
You, yes. Yes. Birch. Was Fred's favorite.
I know, talking to Petra paid off.
Way to go, Jesse! Congratulations! That was...
Oh my god, actually talking to Petra paid off.
Not the only one surprised by this turn of events. As your prize, you will spend one night in Fred's house. Be careful not to disturb its contents. And here are your sleeping garments. The true... Mark of Fred. Only the champion gets to wear these.
But Kent have them.
You know, Kent did a great job out there. He should have the, sleeping garments.
You would really...
Why, if only tailored them to my exact size. You know.
Here's an idea.
The size of everything else. Oh, Kent.
Jesse. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Thank you. I will murder Romeo in cold blood.
Okay, if I were a weapon of some sort.
Let's do some investigating. Okay. Books. Soren, right?
Whoa, half the pages are gone. And the rest, there are a lot of notes.
Oh, I didn't look at the other side of the room. Get off the... Okay, books. Oh, a closet. It's Fred.
Nothing in here now.
A button.
That button.
Push the button.
It's a... Whoa, secret room.
Oh, mine.
There's gotta be something down here.
Whoa. Is that the only thing I can look at? Oh no, more books.
This book contains the collective knowledge of the survivors. We're an underground group of survival experts who have been around since the early days. Yeah, it goes on. Signed by the chief.
Cool. You almost burnt down the book. Let's check out this. Fred's Keep, the Oasis, and... Romeo Berg.
Three towns. There's the Oasis there and the keep. Third is Romeo Berg. Seriously? What kind of name is Romeo Berg?
Okay. Sticks. Has to be something else. Oh, book. Burnt your face.
Fred's journal. I don't know what Romeo wants anymore. It hurts. All I wanted was the three of us together. Maybe we should have never left the cabin.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't just happy there. We were home. Wait. Home? And he wasn't talking about here. There wasn't a cabin on the map, though.
Okay.
Nothing else in here. Maybe the others found something. Finta!
Jesse, I... There's something I need to ask you.
Okay, shoot.
How did you know the answer to that last question? It's not common knowledge, and it was shared with me in great confidence before... Well,
Zara told me.
Underneath.
I knew because Zara told me. She knew Fred better than anyone.
Zara? As in Fred's Zara.
The Zara.
Zara.
One and only.
She hasn't been seen down here in a very, very long time. You're more impressive than you seem. Maybe they're right after all. Maybe you are from above the bedrock. Rumors have been going around since your arrival. Your friend Jack spoke of all these lands we've never heard of.
Yeah, about that.
Well, did you at least find what you were looking for? This weapon? I don't know why Fred would have one, but I must admit I'm curious.
Not the weapon exactly, but some promising clues. Romeo, Zara, and Fred had a cabin that they called home. We need to find it.
Romeo? Did they say Romeo?
The admin?
Yes, the admin. Right now he's in our town, pretending to be me. We need to stop him. Problem is, we don't know where the cabin is.
I want to help you, but there's something I need from you in return.
Murder the admin.
If you're really from up there, then you must have a way back. Take us with you, above the bedrock.
Above? Vita, what are you saying? We don't know what's out there.
It has to be better than this.
We will help you.
And if Romeo...
You welcomed us in. Of course we'll help you.
Thank you.
Sounds like you may have to do some convincing.
They'll come around. The mycelium on this island has kept the monsters from spawning, and we've been safe here so far. But it won't last. Our only chance for a real future is up there.
Zara's repairing the portal that will take us up. If you want to go through, meet us at the oasis.
Fred left this to me before he...
Dang it!
The needle points home. When he didn't come back, I tried to follow it, but got stopped at the gates to Romeoburg. They've got a massive army, so be careful. Please... Take good care of it. You've shown I can trust you to...
Thank you!
You didn't have
Fred wouldn't want me to be polite.
You, really.
You're very welcome. I'll prepare my people. You take these.
Fireworks?
Signal us when you're ready, and we'll be there.
Great, you're here. We've got a new destination, so...
You go on ahead. I'm gonna stay here. See what I can do to help.
What? No, Jack, we have to stick together.
Not this time. We're the best chance they've got to get out. Us and that portal Zara's fixing. I can do some good here. Help Binta convince them.
Jack, what are you talking about?
You're a good guy, Jack. Helping these people is the right thing to do.
Thank you, Jesse. I hoped you'd see it that way.
Huh?
Friends don't leave friends behind.
It won't be for long. Once you get the weapon, we'll get out of here. Just like we planned.
You're not even gonna let us try to change your mind, are you?
No. Petra, I...
Whatever.
I thought her text used to be blue.
We'll see you at the oasis.
When you set off that firework Binta gave you, I'll come running. And hopefully I'll have a few new friends with me.
Aw, oh, Raider's coming with us. Achievement. No? Oh, yay. Was that chapter 2, 3? That was a long chapter. We're 50 minutes in. We're only a third of the way through this. She will punch you.
So, what's the compass saying? We still heading the right way?
Hang on, let me check. Seems like we're still on. Tracks out, everybody brace yourselves.
Oh, we're dead.
Rough ride. Man, the track is a complete wreck. Yeah, what's up with...
The ninja! Oh, and I have no sword.
Oh,
Hi there, my name's Jesse. And you are
Fred.
Come on, seriously, who are you?
I have a shadow sent to eliminate all imposter Jessies.
But I am Jesse.
Oh, really? Then prove it. Tell me something that only Jesse...
Is that Gabriel?
Alright, you want to know something only Jesse could know? How about the fact that I wear blue underwear?
If you're trying to make me so uncomfortable that I leave, it isn't working. Nope. Sorry. I'm not convinced. Sword time! Say your goodbyes, imposter!
Alright, I've been super patient with you, but I'm done. If you don't get your dumb sword out of my face this minute, you'll regret it.
Ah, yes. I'd know that threatening tone anywhere.
You are the real Jesse.
Wait, what? Pee-wee?
Ivor?
Yes, it is I, your friend Ivor. I'm a ninja now, Jesse!
What? Yeah, what?
It all started when I fell through a portal into some sort of
Ivor!
Strange world. Everything was all white. Master Shadows to me.
He's a ninja?
He's a ninja master, a practitioner of the shadow arts. At first, I wanted nothing to do with him. He was a very suspicious
character. So let him talk it out.
After a lot of uncomfortable eye contact, he asked me, to be his pupil. I was confused at first because he didn't exactly present his credentials or curriculum, but I'm always open to learning. I'm a student of life after all, so I said yes. Before I knew it, I was punching trees, cleaning floors, all as part of my so-called training. At first, it seemed... But after I had punched a forest's worth of trees and cleaned miles and miles of floor, two things became clear. Sometimes, doing menial tasks can be an amazing way to learn martial arts. And sometimes, strange old men just like tricking people into doing their housework. Anyway, it all worked out because now I'm a ninja. And my newfound ninja skills helped me find my way to you.
Are you done? Please be done.
Huh, yes! I suppose I'm doing a lot of talking. I just had a lot to say after all of that quiet and mysterious business. It's so good to see you.
I'm so confused.
You missed me. Hang on, you tried to kill me.
Yes. That was an unfortunate way to reunite. Let me explain. You see, it all started when Harper and I returned from our vacation. We discovered that while we were gone, you had mysteriously vanished after fighting a prismarine giant named the Admin.
Right.
Only to return, having defeated this Admin and taken his amazing powers.
Wait, what?
Yeah, that's not right.
Wow, I gotta admit, the Admin cooked up a pretty smart plan. That's good.
Are you kidding me?
Jesse's right. Now the Admin gets to be Jesse and have Admin powers. Pretty good deal. Jesse, aka
the Admin,
gave me this and told me he had reprogrammed it to find the fraud, aka you. But with my new ninja senses, I could tell something wasn't right. Anyone who disagrees, anyone who questions Jesse, disappears.
Oh, they must hate me.
It's certainly not helping your reputation. No, but I knew that Jesse, the real Jesse, would never act like that. That's why I decided to try and use this opportunity to discover the truth. Luckily, it worked out because I would have felt terrible.
Wait, so how did you get here? And if you can tell me, we can go home.
Sick thing to say to your friends.
I can tell you're being sarcastic, but You'd be surprised.
Wait. If you weren't convinced, you would have killed me?
The admins turned everything upside down, Jesse. It's very confusing up there. Speaking of whom, I can't spend much more time down here. If I don't get back to the prison soon and report in, the admin will know that something isn't right.
That's perfect. You can make up a lie and you'll never suspect that I'm actually down here.
Which will buy you the time you need to find Fred's weapon.
Hold on! How'd you know about
I'm
that?
I'm a ninja! Anyway... I'm a ninja!
It's all well and good,
but what exactly should I tell the admin? It needs to be plausible, but dramatic.
Yeah, believable, but entertaining.
Realistic, but shocking.
Tell him I died trying to flee the Sunshine Institute. Fluff up his ego. Let him think that he built an inescapable prison.
Oh, yes. A fed ego is a happy ego, after all. I'm sorry I can't stay longer, but I must go.
Go. We'll see you when we get back to the surface. No, wait. Can I borrow that amulet?
Certainly, but why?
Long story involving a portal and a magic frame, but it'll help us get home.
Please hurry. It's getting dire up there. Smoke bomb!
He's over there.
You saw nothing.
We all just saw that, right? I didn't like hallucinate Ninja Ivor.
Nuh-uh.
Just when I thought that crusty dude couldn't get any weirder.
And we're ready to roll. Come on, guys.
That was weird. This is a very long episode, by the way. A Friend in Need. Chapter 3. 57 minutes in.
Looks like the compass is pointing right to that building.
Oh, good. It only sounds like there are a few thousand big scary people between us and there.
Halt! You there! What business have you?
I think we need to go into that building behind you.
If that's okay!
It is in fact not okay, okay? Now just move along and don't go anywhere near the building or we will sick our army on you.
Or we'll sick our army on you! Wouldn't want to unleash the force of our army.
And it's a mighty army.
Yes, we've heard amazing things about your army. Because we're the new recruits.
But Jesse, we're not going to... Well, that's great. We should let him in. Because we really don't have
Shut
a...
Shut it!
Oh, they don't have an army.
Doubt your claims. See this? This is my doubty face. Hey, army! You too, Jeff. Let's take these invaders out!
That's weird.
It's not weird. The army just took a power nap. Now they're stronger than ever. Yeah. Thanks to their nap. Yeah.
There's no army.
I'm gonna ask you again, all right? You just skedaddle before our well-rested army makes you regret it. We're gearing up. Yeah, it's the biggest army you've ever heard right here.
Bring out your army. I'm happy to take them on.
Oh, and they're happy to take you on, but, they're still getting ready, and it's gonna
There's no army.
And you'll just get bored waiting, so you should probably just leave.
Alright, we don't have an army, exactly.
But what about Jeff?
Yeah, I know, but, still can't let you in. Sorry.
Really, it's for your own good. That building you're pointing at? That's Romeo's challenge.
Yeah, it's nothing more than a death trap. The worst kind of trap.
Which is why
what about mousetrap?
Keep everyone out. Even relentless travelers like you. I mean, you should thank us for keeping you away from it, okay? We're doing you a solid.
I escaped Romeo's highest security prison, the Sunshine Institute. I think I can handle some little challenge.
Whoa, that's hardcore.
Whoa, yeah. Anyone who escaped that place? Mad props. Open
The gate!
Jeff, open the gate!
No, Soup. The gate. Yeah, the real gate. Right. On it.
Aww.
Whoa, weird llama.
Is that Jeff? Yeah.
This place is a wasteland.
Yeah, having a town where everyone enters a mysterious challenge room then never comes out will do that.
I suppose that, might affect population levels a little.
We still don't feel good about permitting you in the challenge room, especially unarmed. But we'll trade you some gear if you can build something to scare off future unwanted visitors.
You know, like a snowman.
Or a huge flower. Just make something that will help us strike fear into the hearts of all who see it. Keep people off our backs.
Something to give us a little me time.
Okay, let's see what I can make. A nice surface. I can make a volcano. Do one more layer. Okay. Oh, no, I don't want that. No. Okay, here we go. Do a layer of this. A layer of this. Put this on top. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So ugly. Trying to use every block. Okay. Gotta use every block, every single one. Also gonna put them in the corners. Boom. Put these here. Spin around with the opposite way. And we can go 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Then this is so ugly. Okay, and now we do one right there, and one right there. Oh, they are just gonna love it. I didn't think you were gonna use all our stuff. What, you thought wrong? 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we go. Boop. 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 Boop, and finally, boop, finished. It's perfect.
Oh, wow. That will give me nightmares. Well done.
Yeah, that will give him nightmares, all right. So bad. Ooh! Okay, let's see. Straps and straps. Armor number 7. Feeling cute. Dented danger. Please don't hit me. Llama brownish. Goofball glory. And a tooth chipper. We have to go with armor number 7. I have no sleeves. Where's your shirt? Oh, I got my sword.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Doomed
poor souls. Okay, Ursula. Radar, why don't you have a shirt on now? So you went from a nice kid to tattoos, a sleeve tattoo, and now no shirt. Radar, what happened to you? Those are cool statues. There's three doors.
This was meant for the three friends, Romeo, Zara, and Fred.
So she must, her skin used to be purple. Maybe they are. Maybe let's not stab them. Gotta recharge my stamina. Ow! Oh, the water! Come on. Oh, it worked.
It's mining time.
Hey. Your body is now my body.
Congratulations, challengers. Stage 1 of 600. Complete.
What?
Stage 2.
Oh, God.
No way we're making it to stage 600.
Three levers got us into this, so.
So maybe those three levers will stop it.
Come on, Radar. Let's bust that machine.
Whoosh. Oh, my God. Hold on, let me take a second.
Break the machine, I'll cover you.
On it.
Oh, God. Oh, am I gonna shoot the pistons? That's pretty cool.
Nice shooting, Jesse.
Thanks, Petra. Radar, hurry up.
Come on. Why don't you come with me?
No, brr.
That was too close.
Now, prepare yourselves for
That's just not fair.
I see your smile.
No one is smiling.
Now, I'm not a monster. There is a crafting table nearby.
This guy has a twisted way of playing with his friends.
Maybe we can bring this one down with water too.
Ow, my hand!
Alright, mine them down to size.
My arm. Again, I'm not paying attention. And my other arm! No!
pickaxe anyway, so I guess it's time for another idea.
We have gunpowder!
TNT!
Just gotta get some sand and we're set.
Right, good thinking, Radar.
Radar, get ready. Fire incoming!
Just need four sand blocks, quickly.
Punch, 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 punch. That's a little more than four. No!
Gunpowder placed like an X. Sand on all four sides. Come on, craft, craft, craft!
I know, it's very slow. Oh no, I did it wrong! Oh, I'm dead. I didn't know how to make TNT. Oh, I'm dumb. I got it this time for sure. I thought I did it right.
Hey, Gola, over here.
Oh, I did the sand again. Uh-oh. Please go back. Please go back.
Gunpowder placed like an X. Sand on all four sides. Come on, craft, craft, craft!
Make. Okay.
You're supposed to light this thing. That might work.
My leg! Oh god, the floor. Fireworks.
We stumble on a hidden stage.
Oh my god. And that was only chapter 4. There's still two more. Oh, this place is nice. Don't even take your shoes off.
I'll meet you over there.
At the cabin.
For Fred.
A birch tree.
Did Romeo do all this?
Maybe he regretted it. In the end.
Let's talk to Petra.
How's it looking?
Doesn't seem to be anybody around. Nobody inside. Should be safe. Safe-ish.
Okay.
Let's just get that weapon and get out of here.
It's like the one we used to have back at the treehouse. Tell someone, you broke it.
Uh-huh.
More books.
Remember I used to read all the time? No, I barely do.
Things change.
Yeah. Petra? What's wrong?
Nothing. It just reminds me of this story about
puppies.
Really cat story. You know me, I can't help crying about dumb stuff like that. Puppies, little chickens.
Come on, Petra, you're lying. We both know it.
No, puppies just make me really sad, okay? Fine, it's
the kittens.
Doesn't this remind you of anything? Our friends? We used to hang out in that treehouse all the time. Now, we barely talk. Why does this keep happening? Everyone leaves and I'm just by myself again. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I see them one by one just...
Not everyone leaves, Petra. I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, but maybe that's the problem. What if I want to go somewhere that isn't Beacon Town? I'll just be alone again. Axel and Olivia are barely around. Who knows how much longer Jack's gonna stay with us?
She has abandonment issues.
Didn't take long for the new Order of the Stone to fall apart, did it? My fault for thinking it would be different. Held together longer than most. That doesn't make it hurt any less, though.
People change, Petra. They grow apart sometimes. That's not a bad thing.
That's easy for you to say. I'm the one who always ends up alone.
Oh.
I know this isn't important right now. Let's just find the weapon and get out of here.
It's the book, isn't it?
Something's not right here.
The beds don't go with the banners?
Next? Oh, I have to rearrange the bed to how it makes sense. Oh. Okay, so. X.
Purple for Zara. That did something. One down. Now the rest of these need to go in the right order.
Blue.
Blue for Fred. Red for Romeo.
Wait, another book.
That's the weapon? What are we supposed to do with potato? That's not a weapon. It's a root vegetable, and not a very good one.
That's what it is? That's so dumb.
Hashtag potato 451.
I still have hope for Romeo. He just wanted us to stay together more than anything. I know that's why he's doing this. Maybe I'm being foolish, but I need to know for sure before taking this step. Though I guess if you're here, I got my answer. Maybe someday we'll be together again. Your friend always, Fred.
Aww.
I kind of feel bad for them. Don't you?
This wasn't easy for any of the admins.
They really cared about each other. Everyone talks about Romeo like he was this controlling monster, but Fred wrote that Romeo just wanted to keep them together, more than anything. Isn't that what I've been doing? Especially to you? I don't want you to feel forced to keep doing something you don't want to. I don't want to be that person, or make you feel scared to tell me the truth.
You are nothing like the admin. Don't compare yourself to him.
Even he didn't start out that way. It just got bad. I don't want to cross that line, too.
So don't.
I've been thinking a lot about what you said. Adventuring is what I'm good at. It's where I belong. Not in Beacon Town. But I don't want to lose you. You mean a lot to me, Jesse. More than anyone else, you've been there. And I don't want to leave if it means you're my best friend, Jesse.
I'll be right there with you, Petra. You think your place is out there, then so is mine.
Oh, she's gonna cry.
Thank you.
I always knew you were a big old softy.
You'll never be able to prove it.
Radar? Want to show the footage? Always make sure radar's glasses are always recording. I feel like we still had to do something there. So her skin used to be purple. It's very confusing. Or it's just a logo to her town.
Whoa, she did it.
Ooh.
This is it then.
It's time to call the others. We're getting out of here.
We're here.
What do you think you're doing? The portal is hidden for a reason, to keep things away.
This is our way to get Jack and Nurm. We need them.
Right. That won't be a burden. Sounding pretty admin-ish there, Zara.
The weapon is what we need, not bodies to throw at the problem. People just complicate things, make everything messy, inefficient.
No one gets left behind, ever.
Like the llama.
I mean, that's not exactly true.
Yes, that furry one, the weird horse. You left her in the prison.
But we need it. Well, from now on, then.
Might be your downfall, waiting on others. Better be careful about that. As you can see, the portal's fully functional. You complete your end?
Yep, I think this should send us home. And there's Fred's weapon.
A book.
Potato.
Weird, right? I thought it was weird.
Fred trusted him. He went to Romeo with the best of intentions and was... Ugh. There is no redemption in Romeo. None. He needs to be stopped once and for all. He deserves it. Worse. For this and everything else, it's the only way.
If it comes to that, maybe.
Jesse, we can't just take him out. There is no maybe. Heroes are supposed to help people, not hurt them. Romeo deserves what's coming to him. Fred should be avenged. Fred was the best of us, cut down. I can't let it stand.
Going after revenge would make us just like Romeo, Zara. We're better than that.
Yeah. Well, I guess we'll have to see if Romeo understands anything but violence. Romeo destroyed my world, and I wasn't there to help it. He's stolen it from me. There is no rebuilding. I have nothing now.
That's not true.
It's really
are good things left if you look for them.
That you would... I'm not used to being wrong.
Oh, snap. I'm used to being wrong all the time.
Thank you. But we still need to move forward. All right. Let's get this over with.
Are my friends here yet?
Hand over that trinket of yours.
Jesse?
No! No! Oh god, I had my controller down.
It's the Fred folk.
Nope, monsters.
Not the people from Fred's Keep. Those are mobs.
Regular mobs.
Just what we needed.
Find me a bed when I had been so unhelpful.
Go. Mobs don't stand a chance.
Okay. Stab it in the face! Ow.
Jesse, help! Don't let it eat me! I'm really not tasty!
Endermen don't eat people. Did it. They're all dead.
I will not run anymore.
Stupid move. Wait, is it actually gonna eat me? Kick him, please. Whoa! It's Yak!
Looks like all my training for the marsh hoppers of the Harlying Swamps totally paid off.
Jack!
Jack!
Hey guys, pretty cool, right?
For Fred's Keep! For the future! Fight!
Fight! Oh, Jesus. They're decimating them. Mache. Oh, X! Oh, mix it up!
Doesn't like a little pressure to make building fun.
And there we go. It's not pretty, but it'll do. Everyone, let's go!
Everyone, we are leaving!
Oh boy, radar.
We're winning, for now. But they're not going to be able to hold that line for much longer. Especially not if that Enderman takes the portal apart. It's bad news.
It's after me.
Because I'm the toughest. Oh, that poor spider.
More bad news. I think it likes me. That means I can be a distraction.
Yeah, if you want to be stuck down here.
I know. But if I do that, it'll let everyone get...
You got nothing to prove, man. How come I can't be the distraction?
The Enderman is after me. I can buy you time.
You're our friend, Radar. We're not leaving you down here. We have to stick together.
This is my time, Jesse. I know it. I have to do this.
No, we do it together. Save Fred's people. Oh, he's not coming back.
Get some of this. Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm talking about these huge arms.
He has this. He's giving us an opening. Everyone now, Kent, come on.
Kent, specifically.
You could ask more nicely.
But where?
Anywhere's got to be better than here.
I'm not gonna go back for him? Okay, Radar, now you just have to run back. Stupid picture.
Oh, pain everywhere.
That's it. No more mystery portals ever.
Norm!
What Norm said. That was not a quality three-point landing. Sorry, Nermy.
Oh god, they're all dead!
Is everyone alright?
It's the Old Order's temple! We did it! We're back!
Radar would be flipping out if he were here right now.
Give him a second, he'll pop through.
I mean, come on. You know he'd be all over historical Order of the Stone sites.
He'll make it back to us. He'll just be a little...
Late? Sure. Bet that'll bother him, too. He's always on time. Jesse, we are endlessly grateful to your friend for what he did for us.
We'd thank him if we could. We didn't know if we'd ever see the sky again.
But behold, there it is.
Did you see that?
Okay, somebody tell me I'm losing it. Is that?
Beacon Town.
It looks great now. It's all symmetrical and stuff. Damn, that was a long chat. That was a long episode. It looks like I chose the scavenger's deal. You're damn right I won. I promised this dame of Petra. I did give her a bed. Let's see what's happening next time on Minecraft Story Mode. Oh, Lucas!
Jesse, man, is it good to see you. Where are the others?
Man, this is a stupid picture. Okay, I think that's it. That was the fourth episode of Minecraft Story Mode, Season 2. Got one more. Tomorrow we can finish up Guardians of the Galaxy, Telltale Games, and I don't know. Let's see what that gamer score is now. I don't know how to see my gamer score. Do I have to scroll down? Nope. Okay, we'll just wait for this to load. Okay, we're gonna go home. So now, after tomorrow, when we beat the Guardians of the Galaxy last episode, we'll finally hit 22,000 gamer score after 6 years. Because that's how bad I am at video games. But until then, just scroll back. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.